I wonder whether you have ever looked at one particular aspect of life. What is the average age of all of us? Average human being lifespan. Some people live for 16, some people live for 80 years, some people live for 70 years. Let us take an average lifespan to be 75 years. And normally, 75. Many people live for 90, many people live for 50. But normally, if you take 75 years as the normal lifespan, I don't know whether you have thought. Out of these 75 years, we sleep for 25 years. Out of the 75 years, we sleep for 25 years. That means one day is 24 hours. If you take an average of 8 hours of rest of sleep, sometimes you sleep for 6, sometimes you sleep for 10. If you are studying more, sometimes you have to work hard, sometimes you are studying. Sometimes if you are like a very prominent member like our minister here, we will have to go around. Doctors around 8 hours rest. That means 1/3 of a day. So out of 24 hours, we rest for 8 hours. That means 75 years we live. 25 years we are spending on sleeping. The single longest human activity is sleep. So we have got 50 years left. The next 8 hours we spend on education and employment. Small ages, you go to kindergarten schools, then you go to forms, standards, college, then after that you go for your employment, your career. Another 8 hours, you spend it like this. So if you start from this, if our life starts from this and ends on this, 0 to 75, 25 years for sleep, 25 years for education and employment. What is left is 25 years. Or 8 hours per day. Out of that 8 hours, normal human being, half of it, the rest 8 hours, half of it, 4 hours, he spends for relationships. Your Janma Bandha and Karma Bandha. Your father, mother, sister, brother, grandfather, grandmother, uncle, aunt. Even if you are an orphan, you have to spend an orphanage, the person who picks you up. And then later, you fall in love. You will have kids, grandkids. So 4 hours means almost 12.5 years. 25 years for sleep, 25 years for education, employment, 12.5 years for relationship. The rest is another 12.5 years or 4 hours per day. Out of that 4 hours, every day, 1 hour, normally 1 hour, we spend for our routines. We spend for our leadership. Go to brush, you bath, you make food, you have coffee, tea, snacks, whatever it is. Normally, you spend 1 hour. 1 hour is the minimum you can take. Then, 3 hours are left. That means, another, say, around 10 years left. 3 hours. Normal human beings, out of that 3 hours, spends around 2.5 hours for entertainment. You go on changing channels in TV, in the internet, or you keep on sending SMS in modern generation. Or you simply spend time, simply give up time, you go to your hobbies, you go to movies, you go to Genting Island, you go to Kuala, you go to other places, you have entertainment, you go to places. So the disposable time with us is very less. If you have observed, almost 95% of our human life is predetermined, is already fixed by God. You cannot change your sleep. Because if you are only sleeping for 4 hours continuously for a week, after 1 week you will break down. You cannot not go to school. You have to go to school. You have to go to employment. You have to earn a living. You cannot not spend time on relationship. Your mother, grandfather, grandmother, brother, sister, your kid, your love, your friends, your society. Or you cannot spend time on routines. Can you not brush your teeth or bath or spend time for. So 95% of our time in life is preset, is predetermined. The disposable time we have, disposable means if you are having say 20,000 ringgits per month and you have to fill in loads for 15,000 ringgits, you will have 5,000 ringgits as the disposable income or spendable income. The spendable time in our life is very less, it's very short. And Swami Vivekananda says, out of say 75 years or 80 years to live, if you can at least spend 1/20, 4 to 5 years to search the deeper dimensions of life. 3 things. 1, yourself. 1, the world. And 3, the God. Then you will attain moksha. And what I say, the relevance is because our time in this world is very limited and the disposable time is more limited. And there are 4 ways, 4 paths, or in ancient our terminology we call it yoga. Yoga doesn't mean all the yogasanas. Yoga comes from a word called yuj. Yuj means to join. To join your jivatma, paramatma. To join our ayyappans with that ayyappan. So there are 4 particular yugas or yoga or yogas. There are 4 paths. All religions are these paths. 4 paths are bhakti yoga, attaining God through bhakti, karma yoga, attaining God through selfless service, charity, social work, helping others, loving thy neighbor as Jesus Christ calls it. Bhakti yoga, karma yoga, raja yoga. Raja yoga means meditation. Esoteric practices, dhyana, spiritual knowledge, these are all called Raja Yoga. And finally, is Jnana Yoga, knowledge, or attaining God through knowledge, the Baba. Everyone sitting here, every friends and Malikapurans, every men and women sitting here, have either preferences for one path or a combination of one or two paths. There may be some people who are very devotional, who take a lot of interest in bhakti, singing songs, rituals, that kind of pattern. Their path is not pure. There may be some other people who are more interested in saying that praying hands, praying lips and helping hands are equally important. They say social work, karma yoga. Gandhiji was a karma yogi. Other places are they say karma yoga. So they will say karma is very important. Other people, Raja Yoga, they are realization of Swamis. Swami Vivekananda or Art of Living organizations, they seek God through meditation. We one with them, Raja Yoga. Finally, Jnana Yoga, we one with them. Or Shankaracharya, Ramanuja, Madhuacharya, they were people who sought God with knowledge. We all have preferences to one or the other path. And Shabrimala's legend is a combination of all paths. And all paths are equally valid. For example, Christianity, as they call it, the path of Jesus, Kumarga, is a combination of more of selfless work and bhakti yoga. It's a combination of bhakti and selfless work. Every religion will have it. For example, Buddha. Buddha was a combination of Raja Yoga and Karma Yoga. He says work and change. Islam, the same, is a combination of bhakti and raja. More similar to the other systems, saying you have to do your namas, you have to do your systems.